In this video, we show you how Power BI relationships can replace an army of Excel VLOOKUPs. Keep watching. Now that's perfect, but we have a whole product table. We have this product table with all these rich attributes that we talked about. So we want to be able to slice and dice the sales amount by all these attributes. Well, can we do that? Let's give that a try. So I'm going to remove product key from here and instead go to the product table and grab category and drop it in there. Now watch what happens. Now this is probably not what you expected. This certainly seems wrong. And you see what's happening? Now this is what I call the repeating number pattern. And you're gonna see it a few times, and almost always it indicates trouble. Not always, there's some cases where that's exactly what you want, but almost always when you see a repeating number pattern like this, there's some trouble involved. And the first thing that I look for, the very first thing, is that is there a relationship between these two tables. So the category is coming from the product table and the sales amount is operating on the sales table. Are they connected in a relationship? And you can see that they're not connected in a relationship. There's no line indicating a relationship between them. Now, well, let's talk about that. What is a relationship? Think about it this way. If you were in the old world and you had the sales table, let's go over here, and you had the sales table, which had the product key 314, and you had a different table, product, which had the same key, of course, somewhere in there, and the name, subcategory, category. How would you handle that? Well, you would do it using VLOOKUP. Gosh, yeah, I've written my fair share of VLOOKUPs back in the day. So you would say VLOOKUP product key from this table to that table, and then get category, subcategory. Essentially, you would flatten the table out, right? And you would get all of that. So you would have to write quite a few VLOOKUP columns to get all the product attributes. But in this new world, you don't need to do that. You don't need to write an army of VLOOKUPs. You can simply connect these two by a relationship. So the same columns that you would have used for the VLOOKUP, you would have said VLOOKUP this product key and find it there. The same column, you're just gonna drag and drop and connect it together in a relationship. So that's all you need to do. And once you've done that, now if I go back to my report view, boom, you see that it's fixed, it's working by category. And in fact, this would work by any other attribute I drop in there. So if I drop in color, boom, it shows me by category color, product category, subcategory. So anyway, all of those would work. You can slice and dice that measure by using any attributes simply by the virtue of this relationship. So relationships are in a way the end of VLOOKUPs. So imagine how many VLOOKUPs you would have had to write to flatten not just the product attributes, but territories, customer, calendar. And now we're just gonna run through this and connect all the other tables. And this is so much easier than writing that army of VLOOKUPs. So we're gonna connect customer key to customer key. And last one, sales territory key to sales territory key. Perfect. Actually, I'll show you this one again. So this might change, frankly, over the release. Different releases of Power BI Desktop, I've seen different behavior, but at least for right now, it doesn't matter which direction you drag and drop it. So even if I drag and drop from the lookup to the data table, it still connects it, and it still connects the same way. And lastly, if you want complete control over that, you can go to the Home tab and click Manage Relationship. And you can either edit or create a new relationship from there. So I can say, I want to connect sales table to territories, and usually it selects the matching column. If not, you can select it for yourself. You can say, yep, use these columns. Many to one is good, single is good, and hit okay. All right, so now we have all the tables connected. We can go crazy. We can just go in there and now we can slice and dice the sales amount using really any table. We can say customer. Or pick something from territories. Or a combination of the elements. Maybe I can add customer gender in here as well. So you get the idea, once the relationships are there, they let you slice and dice your data table any way you want. So we have our sales table connected, but we haven't shown any love to our budget table. Let's take a look at that. So we're gonna bring in our budget amount. Perfect, I'm gonna change it to a table. Great, make that a little bigger. And again, if we try to add an attribute from the product table, if we add category, we get the same repeating number pattern, but we know exactly what to look for. The first thing to look for is there a relationship between these two tables? There isn't. So we're just going to create one using the key already there, product key. And while we're here, we're going to connect the month to the calendar table as well. So we're here and you can see this fixed itself. And again, you can kind of slice and dice this any which way you want. So we're going to talk a whole lot more about relationships, about data lookup tables, the direction of the relationships, many to one, one to many, all of that stuff is coming later. But next up, we're going to talk about one of my favorite topics, measures. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.